Hi everyone, how do you do? Today I'm going to speak about the dynamic dropdown list, and I will show you how to create it from an array. And at the end, I will introduce you a function to search within the dropdown list. Since it was a little advanced, I didn't cover it in this video. But if you are interested, tell me in the comments and I will make a video for it. Let's create a dynamic dropdown list together. In this example, I have a list of sale amount for different clothing items in different countries. I want to create a dynamic drop-down list and calculate the summation of each item for each country. Alright, let's get started. Since we want a dynamic drop-down list, we need to convert the list to a table. Select a cell inside the list and press Ctrl T. Excel selects the entire range, press on OK. First, let me remove the table format from here, it's better. Now it is time to define the dropdown list. Select the cell that you want to apply the dropdown list on it, and from the Data tab, click on the Data Validation icon. In the OpenEd window, since we want to define a list, in the Allow section, select List. And in the Source section, select the range of items. Since we have converted the list to a table, you can hover your mouse at the top of the header, and when mouse cursor shape change to the bold down arrow, click on it. And click on OK. Now, if you select the drop-down list, there is a problem. The list is full of duplicates. No, I don't want it. I want a unique list. For solving this problem, we need to first extract the unique items from the list and then define the dropdown list. But how can I extract the unique items from the list? With the help of the unique function. In this cell, I type equal unique and select this range, enter. Now I can see the unique items from the list. It is time to edit my dropdown list. First, select the cell that contains the dropdown list and click on the data validation icon. We have to edit the source data. Remove the previous source and select the new unique items. No. Don't do this. We want a dynamic dropdown list. If I chose this range at first, it was because the selected range was inside the table. But since the unique items are not inside the table, if I select this range, I am telling Excel always use this range. And if I add a new item to the table, the dropdown list won't get updated. So what should I do? For solving this problem, you have to address the array. In the source section, select the first cell of the array and at the end, add a hash sign. This hash sign means return the entire array. Alright, everything is perfect. Click on OK. Now, if I click on the dropdown list, I can see the unique items. Let me explain the fundamental of the hash sign. This is the range of the array. If I type equal this cell, Excel shows me G8. And if I drag it down, Excel shows me the selected range. But as soon as I reached to the end of the array, the address changed to the G8 hashtag, which means I'm going to return the entire array. I explained this because I wanted to make it more clear why we added the hash sign in the source section. Anyway, let's get back to the example. If you look at the table, we want to calculate the summation of male underwear in each country. But how can we do that? With the help of the SUMIFS function. I have explained the SUMIFS function in this video completely. The link is in the description. In this cell, I type equal SUMIFS. Select the sale amount as summation range, comma. Select the closing items as criteria range 1, comma. What is my criteria? Male underwear, comma. Select country as criteria range 2, comma, and select these countries as criteria 2, enter. You can see the result. If I change the male underwear to the jacket, you can see the sale amount for the jacket in each country. But I said it is a dynamic drop-down list. Let's check it. I add child clothes to the table. Do you see that? The child clothes added to the array. Let's see the drop-down list. You can see it here too. I don't like the presence of the unique list in my sheet. You can transform it to another sheet, or you can hide the column. If you have a very long list, finding items within the list is kind of impossible. But I am using a function which lets me to search in within the drop-down list. For example, if I type my name, you can see the results. I want Said Faal, so I select it. Since this function is a little advanced, I didn't cover it in this video. But if you want me to cover it in a separate video, tell me in the comments.